Previously.
I'd just like to go, please. It's just too much. I just can't deal with it.
I'd just like to leave, please. I'm really sorry to mess you around, but I want to at least stay in here for a week.
I just want to go home now.
Tonight, I'm going in the Big Brother house. Dear 50, 8:45 a.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom. Joe, Corin and Laura are in the bathroom.
This is my first morning, as you can probably tell. I've woke up and I'm not even remotely tired.
I should have kept my nails on.
Oh, God. I feel really alive today. I'm absolutely shattered. See, this is how I usually wake up, babe.
I don't know why.
I feel knackered.
Do you?
Knackered.
Oh, I'm going to bug everyone because I'm really awake then.
Well, you can spend it away as well.
I know.
It'll kick in for you later.
Out of every morning, this is the most worrying morning I've woke up the best.
Wow, I wish I did. Out of every morning, this is something like
that. I'm absolutely shattered.
That's how I usually wake up. Mind you, it's not good when I feel this hyper kind of mood because I've got nowhere to out, no outlet for it.
What do you mean, no outlet?
Well, I'm going to be stuck. Well, I'm going to be stuck in here, and if everyone's tired, then I'm just going to be the biggest bugaboo.
No, some people will be alright. See that?
Oh, you'll be all right anyway.
You look dark, babe.
Dad.
I'm sure you're going dark through the night.
Yeah, I'm quiet.
Can't do it anymore.
Yeah. Come this way. Come on.
Okay. I can't do it anymore.
Okay.
Like, I thought I'd be able to do it myself, but I'm just not being able to help myself. I'm just like, and I love all people and I can't speak to them.
Yeah.
Now, I couldn't tell them that was going to be. I just would have been just so upset, like, what? I just can't do that.
Yeah. Do you want to go back in and then go through the dining room and say goodbye to everyone?
No, I can't. That would just be too hard. I wouldn't be able to. They'd be just so, like...
You sure?
Mm. 10:20 a.m. It's been 1 hour and 29 minutes since Laura walked out of the Big Brother house. Housemates are unaware she has left.
At some point, no, it's just because you're so good at these things and we've asked you to do this whole silly wedding thing, some point, and don't mention my name or anyone else's, but try and think of how we can have a word with John and JC, because this weird thing of them being like under the covers all the time and like screwing around like they're little children.
I'll have a chat then.
What do you think? I mean, even you got annoyed last.
I don't know. I don't know what the answer is. I don't know why they like it.
I mean, he resorts to being about six around her. Mm. Basically, she's a mutt. It's like she's a pig and he's a piglet, but he needs to suckle at her all the time.
I'm thinking she might have gone.
No. Way.
Just why would she be in there that long otherwise?
Yeah, just talking to them, maybe. She couldn't have gone.
Hey?
Do you think she could just go and then they'll come and get her? She wouldn't leave.
Yeah, around 2 days.
I think they're just talking to her.
I hope so.
Yeah.
I really do.
This is Big Brother. Housemates. Laura has chosen to leave the Big Brother house and will not be returning.
Oh, shit. Oh, that's awful. I really liked her.
Okay. Oh, my God.
They must have said, look, see how you feel in the morning, if you're exactly
they
the same.
They say that, because they've got to put things in motion, haven't they?
Why did she do that, man?
Gutted.
Why did she do that?
Yeah. What a shame.
I knew her nerves were shot. I knew she'd go at some point. She wasn't going to stay.
She had a lot going on in her life. She was
so anxious and stuff, wasn't she? You
but
know
she
what
was
mean?
Doing so well, though.
Yeah.
For a day.
Everybody loved her.
It's just her nerves were really bad. She was shaking and anxious. She was worried about home, wasn't she? Must be so difficult for her.
Yeah.
And another one bites of dust.
That's three walkers.
Three walkers?
All of them and girls. A hobbler.
AM. Some of the housemates are in the bathroom.
Just go to the bathroom a minute. Work your way down to my ear. I didn't see that running. I did it over there. Do you want me to do your
bed? I'll just wait here for a while longer, watch JJ get ready, and then I'll go and have a shower.
What way? Why not, kid?
Yeah, you can look, but you can't touch, innit?
Well...
Not wrong with that. I'm sure you'll be looking on, Joe.
Oh, no. He's coming. I don't step on other people's territory.
Shut up. It's not my territory. Not yet.
Is anyone in the you had a shower bed?
Yeah.
Everyone that shares my bed's left, walked out.
What does that tell you?
Must be me.
That's it, a double bed spare I'm sharing with you tonight, Corinne.
There you go.
I'm joking.
Can share with me if you want, JJ.
Right, I'm going to wash my face and wait for you to get ready.
Yeah. Can't be bothered getting ready.
That's unlike you.
Oh, I hate getting ready. I like it when I'm ready, but I hate getting ready.
Oh, actually doing it.
Yeah. Joe loves it for 4 hours.
Why are you hungry, Wolf? Get up. Oh, it's a prime viewing spot, isn't it?
That was easy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, we'll be in it tonight.
AM. Big Brother has gathered all the housemates in the living room for the start of this week's shopping task.
Woo! Someone's coming in the door! Who's the houseman?
Who is it?
He's
the
postman. Oh my God, he is this. Oh my God, he is.
Oh my God!
Postman.
He's well nice.
Yeah.
Sexy.
Are you allowed to speak?
He's kind of had a doll.
I think so. Unless he's just really shy.
Come on, all right, guys, listen.
He's got to be a stripper, yeah.
Housemates, to pass this week's shopping task, housemates must do nothing at all.
Yes!
Wait! Except for one thing, ignore the obvious. Over the next 3 days, multiple random events will take place in and around the Big Brother house. Housemates are not permitted to react to these events in any way. So stop looking at it.
Ignore the obvious.
Right. Big Brother deems reacting as any of the following: pointing, laughing, gasping, gulping, smirking, screaming.
And that fuck. We're never going to pass this. Fuck's sake.
Flipping monk the most here. How are you going to pass this?
Listen.
Jumping, running away, raising of eyebrows, closing of eyes, flinching, crying, covering of face.
I'm not going to read it.
Right, here we go. That's our silence now.
Go on then, Andrew.
Housemates are not permitted to discuss any of these events with each other. The only place where housemate or housemate may discuss a random event is inside the diary room with Big Brother. A safe is currently being installed in the bedroom. Located inside the safe is a laminate stating number of fails housemates are permitted to occur. If housemates incur the same number of fails stated on the laminate or less, they will pass this week's shopping task and will receive a premium shopping budget. In addition to the premium shopping budget, all housemates will receive a very special prize, an individual message from home. Ignore the obvious will begin when housemates reading these instructions clicks their fingers.
Don't raise your eyebrows,
you're not allowed to laugh off screen. We need a message from home, everyone.
Ignore, ignore.
What, can you not even look?
Ignore.
You're not allowed to giggle.
I know.
You're not allowed to.
Wait, Josie, oh, no. Josie, can you just go on the bathroom and go on the bathroom?
Yeah, go on. Can we just go on?
You go on the bathroom. This is a final task. Ignore.
Rachel, ignore it.
Have fun, eh?
Oh my god.
I love this song.
I love this song too.
Right, I'm going to start putting this stuff away, then I'll do the washing up.
That's a great idea. I think I have you with that.
We can't even
respond
to the music.
All right. Oh, God, nothing.
Egg. You know what? I think the postman really delivered.
(11:22 a.m.) Housemates are unaware that they are permitted to incur no more than 88 fails to pass this week's shopping task. After 11 minutes, they have incurred 11 fails.
Excuse me. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
You've got to ignore everything that goes on. You can't acknowledge it, you can't look at it, you can't laugh at it.
Oh, okay.
Go and talk about it, and that's it.
I'm looking on
this. She can't believe that we call that the obvious.
Quite sweetie pie?
Yeah.
Just do your best. No one can expect you to do any more than that. Okay?
Oh, yeah, I'll do.
I want to, like, pay them to be fair. No, I need you, but, you know, if people are rude to you about it, then tell them to piss off.
Do you think a video message, like, can make you feel like... Because I don't feel like... I won't cry yet or anything about home.
I just want to see my friend's face. Because if I see her face, I know she's all right.
Happy and strong to carry on.
Yeah. I know everything.
You get your mum telling you how good you were out there and all that.
I know everything from my friend's face. I know if everything's all right for me. I know if I'm hated or not. I know, I know.
We've got to do it, Joes. This could be a message for my little kiddies. God, I want this more than anything.
Yeah, I know.
Tea's brewing. Do you want yours as normal?
Yeah, it'd be nice. Cheers, dear.
That's right.
I've got blood all over this. I'm fucking cold sore.
Why is it that time of the month again?
Yeah.
Funny, crack me up, Ben.
I'm going to be a good boy, Ben.
Well, I will. I am a good boy. I only said that to try and cheer her up. That's all.
Yeah.
I didn't mean it seriously. I apologise. I was just trying to cheer her up.
What did you say?
Rachel was saying that everyone was having a bit of a go at her over the task.
What happened was, we were in the bathroom, like, 10 minutes ago, and she starts pouting out. Oh, where's the postman? Where's the postman gone? Oh, so yeah. I said to her, Rach, you're winning the task though. Yeah. You can't go saying that. You haven't even got to acknowledge it. He's there. But then I went to get my trunks on, and when I came out, she'd obviously been bitching to Ben.
And I just.
And then Ben said, if people don't like it, tell them to pee off.
Yeah, but
when I think we're
juice.
A team.
Okay,
and I think
apologize
we should
that.
Work together. Oh, and like, if I'm slipping up, I want you to say, Dave, you shouldn't have.
Yeah, not take because, it
like,
personally.
Because there's people in here that have been here for nearly 8 weeks and they want to, you know, message from home. Course
but I'm
like, that would make a massive difference to him out there.
But I'm one of them.
Is that enough?
I desperately want my. I didn't mean. I was just saying that as a comment to cheer her up. That's all. I didn't mean it.
Yeah, but it sounded. The way you came over, Ben, was almost like, you know what I mean? You were. In some respect, trying to build relationship through with agreeing with something that was
okay,
totally wrong.
No, I can see that. Okay, well, don't worry.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to shaft your mates, dude, just to get up the ladder with her.
Oh, come on, you know that there's no hope of doing that. Anyway, I'm not that sort of person. Come on, Dave, I'm not.
But
like
it's just it's just a typical thing that I've pulled you up on in the past, Ben.
Yeah, all right.
What?
Oh, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
What's happened?
No, it's fine.
p.m. Some of the housemates are in the garden.
Why is that wasp coming? Why is that? That wasp just flew on the dead wasp. Look, it's come to life saving us.
You probably just killed his brother or something, John James.
Oh, they're all going to come back. Oh, no, he's going to tell all his mates.
What? Really?
He's
not happy.
He's
not happy about it. I'll be moving, right? Just flying right near your head.
Fuck. Oh, that's a big one.
Yeah. Oh, maybe that's his, like, mum or something.
Life partner. I reckon that's his... Yeah.
Oh, this might be pretty good.
Oh. You were, like, on top of it.
You just murked his fucking missus.
It just came out of nowhere, didn't it?
Yeah, because he don't want to bury him. He just wants to...
That's how they do it in their world. They chew each other. They don't bury each other.
Just wants to
be here.
I'm quite hot as well. Yeah.
Still dry out.
What's that?
Still dry.
Still, it's really nice weather.
Yeah, good.
It's getting a bit bored today, you know, ain't these days.
Yeah, I think we need to.
I think
we need to have a game of Sounders in a bit.
Oh, yeah.
How would you describe the mood in the house today?
Yeah, I think the mood in the house is okay at the moment. Well, everyone except me.
p.m. Mario and Ben are in the kitchen.
I've got a reasonably good metabolism. I could be a lot faster than I am, but you've got a mega good metabolism.
Oh, dear. Oh, no.
What?
What's going on, Ed?
Oh, shut up.
Oh, dear.
I didn't say I had my metabolism was as good as yours. You are such a bitch in the real world.
No, I'm not. I'm whining you up.
You're a bitch.
You're such a diva.
I'm not a diva. It's a bit nice.
Can you actually say that and believe it?
What?
I'm not a diva.
No, I am a diva.
If I had me pick of anyone who'd come in this house, you know it would be.
Go on.
Can't talk about it, can I?
Who?
Oh, right, no, we can't talk about it.
My mind. Oh, right, yeah.
That's my type. That's all my type. That is my type.
Is it?
Yeah.
You just asked me then in the diary. Which did you find it harder to ignore, the postman or the brass band? I said the brass band, I love that song. Show me the way to heaven. I found it harder to ignore that. I swear to God, I did.
Shut up.
Do you think I'm joking?
No, you're not allowed to mention it.
You fucking idiot.
Ben's friend David has entered the house as a toilet attendant as part of the Ignore the Obvious shopping task.
Yeah, lovely.
Do you have sugar?
Yeah, one sugar.
I didn't want to see me shower naked.
I already did.
Have they got a supply then?
You're right, man.
Yeah, very well.
Have
PM. Some of the housemates are in the garden.
I love your lazy eye.
I love your wispy hair.
I love your regrowth.
I love your hairy cheeks.
I love your hairy back.
What? You're joking?
I love your hairy chest. Just all three hairs that you had.
I love your yellow teeth.
Mario has been called to the diary room. He is unaware that as part of the Ignore the Obvious task, his grandfather is sitting in the chair.
Hello, Mario.
Hello, big brother.
How would you describe the mood in the house today?
Yeah, I think the mood in the house is okay at the moment. Well, everyone except me. Yeah.
Mario, have you been missing your family since arriving in the big brother house?
But I've been missing my family for ages because, you know, my grandparents live in Wales, my mom lives in the States. So, you know, I don't get to see them often anyway, but missing my friends a lot, definitely. And a message from either my family or friends does mean a lot to me, so I don't want to fail this task.
You mentioned your grandparents. Are you missing them?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely, because the summertime now, I would have definitely gone and visited and spent maybe a week with him. I miss her. I miss asking. Yeah, I miss, especially having stories about them, about their childhood. I'm always interested in talking to them about how they were when they grew up and stuff, because we're a million miles away from the world we live in now.
What's your granddad's name?
Eric.
Talk to Big Brother about your granddad, Eric.
I must get my height from him, because we're about... No, actually, I'm taller than him. But I think maybe he shrunk with old age. I think he's 80 now. He's getting close to 80. A little bit shorter than me, white hair, glasses. Just a really, really cool guy.
You mentioned that your granddad has white hair and wears glasses.
Yeah.
Does he ever wear a red coat?
I don't think I've ever seen him wear a red coat.
Five or 1 p.m. Mario and Andrew have come to the diary room.
My question is, was the person sitting next to me my grandfather?
Mario, how would you feel if it had been your granddad?
I'd feel happy because, for one, I know he's okay. Like, there's nothing wrong with him. If it was him, and if he was here, it means that they're okay. He still supports me. And that would make me extremely happy. But at the same time, I'd feel absolutely shit that I just sat next to my grandfather and didn't even...
No, he would have known. He would have known exactly what was. He would have known.
Didn't even look at him to speak to him.
Yeah, but he would have known that's what he had to do.
Rachel, Dave and Ben are in the nest.
Well, Andrew does odd things anyway, and he spends too much time with Mario.
Dude, he's weird, man.
He loves ya.
I love lots of people. I don't grope them and kiss them.
Even I don't do that.
Oh, my God. Did you just say that, Ben?
He looked at me.
Well, what do I do?
Did you just say that, Ben?
I don't. You've never seen me touch anyone in a sexual place.
You don't kiss people, no?
I do kiss people, but I don't grope them, no.
Okay, then. Him?
Yeah, on the cheek, not in the lips, not in an unpleasant way, not in the crotch area.
You would
area.
If you could have, Ben.
Sorry?
You would if you could
no,
have.
No, I wouldn't, because I have too much dignity for that, and you do too.
You don't.
Oh, God, you don't lay off me, do you?
I don't... What are you talking about? You're asking me
you
a question,
I'm always giving me a hard time.
You're always giving me a hard time.
No, I don't. I'm always nice to you. When I see you in the bathroom, I always come up and say hello. I try
Ben, you went from being like one of my best mates in here to not even like speaking to me.
No, you are one of
so
my best friends.
It's a bit hateful, isn't
it? I kept away from you for a couple of days because you were angry with me. What else could
I was angry with you because you just... I was upset. And if you were upset, I'd be concerned, but you just didn't even notice because you were too busy doing Mr. Tickle.
I wasn't doing Mr. Tickle. That's absolutely ridiculous. I thought we had sorted things out yesterday. I thought
we were going to sort things out yesterday, but you didn't have any time in the day.
six forty-one p.m. So far in this week's shopping task, housemates have incurred 14 fails out of a possible 88.
We've incurred a fail.
How do you know?
Oh, here we go. Oh. We've incurred a fail because Ben washing up is such a random event that we weren't supposed to pay any attention to it.
Dear 50, in the Big Brother house, some of the housemates are in the living room.
What are you after?
You just come on toilet duties.
Come on toilet duty.
Glory.
Press the button again, mate.
So much love bubbling out of my belly for you right now, Baron.
Oh, yeah? What for now?
How are we going to fix...
6:42 p.m. Dave and Steve are talking about love.
Steve, how are we going to fix your hat?
I don't know.
It's pretty much knackered.
Six forty-five p.m. Rachel is alone
in the bathroom.
Fancy having a bit of a load?
Are you doing that with two not smoking?
Nobody eats them. 7:01 PM. 11. Josie and John James are discussing having a lie down.
For fuck's sake. Come on, let's go make some of that fucking sugar shit.
Is that a private joke?
Yeah. It's a private joke. I just passed.
It's funny, whatever it was.
Oh, you're funny, you are.
And she went, oh, sugar.
You're
get
funny.
Jaffa cakes out.
Yeah. Is that all we bought? Just like 500
Jaffa cakes?
Jaffa cakes
in the bottom of the thing, don't they?
I don't know.
There's not some Jaffa cakes in the bottom there.
I like your regrowth in your hair today, Josie. Looks very attractive.
Wait till you've got your hair done.
7:05 PM. Some of the housemates are in the living room talking about hair.
Do you want to go to bed, Jos?
Bed.
Jaffa cakes all round, is it?
Good bed with you.
I'll have a Jaffa cake.
Jaffa cake, mate. Lots of Jaffa cake.
Oh.
Yes, please.
I've eaten too much. Pass me a Jaffa.
You going to have a Jaffa cake?
No, Sam. Oh, no, I've eaten too much. It looks so appealing, but I can't fit it in.
You've never knocked back a Jaffa cake before?
No, seriously, I've eaten so much.
7:06 PM. Some of the housemates are in the living room passing round the Jaffa cakes.
I love it, Amy. I'm having the time of my life. I really am.
PM. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
I used to have a little safe like that.
Did you?
When I used to have money.
Dave and Andrew are in the garden.
John is entertaining to watch.
Well, John's got a romance, hasn't he?
Well, yes.
When did they start getting in bed together, like under the covers?
2 weeks ago.
Maybe what, like it is today?
Yeah.
Really?
They used to go to bed together, not as much as they do now, and they never used to go under the covers like that.
Yeah, when, that's what I'm saying. When did maybe they start
a week
doing
ago,
that?
Maybe a week or something, 10 days ago.
Mm, okay.
Why is that?
Well, I thought it might be something to do with him being up for eviction.
Corin has been called to the diary room.
Hello, Corin.
Hiya, big brother.
What's the mood in the house like today?
It's all right, but, like, you're just waiting for things to happen, aren't you? So, you know, it's all right. Yeah, it's just, like, a little bit boring.
Corin. How are you finding this week's shopping task?
It's getting better.
As this is the final series of Big Brother, Big Brother has instructed an estate agent to put the house on the market.
Yep, I think this is going to be the place for you. So, you're up from London, are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. First time into these parts?
We love Bournemouth.
Ignore it.
It's like looking around there, aren't
you? Okay. So, there's the particulars.
Thanks.
Obviously, it's a stone's throw from London.
Okay.
Without further ado.
Okay.
Okay, the living room.
Okay.
Okay, take a moment to get a feel for the place.
It's in his house. See what? Fucking shit house.
Shit everywhere. Shit everywhere. I wouldn't want to live here permanently. I'd go mental, I think, if I lived here permanently.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Yeah?
Nice.
Yeah?
Yep.
Corin?
Yeah?
Have you noticed any random events happening in the house today?
Oh, you're allowed to say.
Corin, you're allowed to tell Big Brother anything in the diary room.
Yeah, everything random, and it's been happening, like the postman, the brass band.
Corin, if you pass this week's shopping task...
What? I can't hear you.
If you pass this week's shopping task...
Yeah?
What will you be requesting from the shopping list?
I'd say air straighteners right now.
Go log.
Do this.
Can't take this, you cocksucker.
What do you feel?
Over here.
Grass.
Grass. But? Plastic grass.
Right.
Yeah. Great. Yeah. Perfect for the gardener. Oh. You don't have to cut the grass. No lawn mowing. But I should mention underneath this, of course.
Yeah.
It's concrete.
Okay.
Pure concrete. A gardener's wet dream.
Oh, that is good, actually.
Yeah.
No moles.
Nope. No moles.
Thousands and thousands of rats, but no moles.
Have a good day.
Corin.
Yeah?
How are you feeling about this week's eviction?
Oh, I'm hating it. Like, you know, it's Ben in it, Dave, John, and Andrew, and they're all, like, dead decent guys. Like, I can't say, like, which way I think it's going to go. But it'll be sad to lose anything. I'm just like that. Like they're feeling gutted. Obviously, I was delighted in the fact. In the fact that I didn't go up. But you know.
Corin, is there anything you're looking forward to in particular over the coming days?
I'm looking forward to it all. I love it. I love it, Amy. I'm having the time of my life. I really am.
So do you want to walk in there? Walk in there. It's not another room.
Okay.
Walk in.
Okay.
Do you want to go?
No, really. It's a gimmick. I'll give you that as a clue. It's a gimmick. And then you tell me what it is. It's a gimmick.
Oh, that cat. Look, sweating.
No, good guess. Look at the, on the side there, the appliances on the side. That will give you a clue what that is. Yeah, the, on the side, yeah. Yeah.
The taps.
You've obviously had a very sheltered upbringing. I can tell that. Here's a clue for you. Here's a clue.
Okay.
Here's a clue.
Okay.
There we go.
A power shower?
It's a power shower.
Oh, right, yeah. So.
Two power showers, walk in.
Oh, right.
He's walked in with his socks on.
Yeah.
It's, you know, needs must, I suppose.
Corin, since the new housemates arrived in the house last week...
Yeah.
How do you think relationships have changed between old housemates and new housemates?
It's changed a bit, hasn't it? I mean, come on, let's face it. Like, I don't really know, but, yeah, it's changed a bit. And, like, I love it because I think that JJ is absolutely well fit. Whoever he thinks, you know, whatever he thinks to me, like, I don't really care because it's, like, nice to have someone... Nice to look at, isn't it?
Great. Well, it's been happy to show you around. I think it's absolutely ideal for you. So, let's get back to my office.
Yeah.
And have a chat about it, shall we?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's funny, because Cos is still in the dining room as well.
Corin, is there anything else you'd like to talk to Big Brother about?
No.
In which case, the diary room door is now open.
Oh, shit your cake hole. Funny with that. Oh, shit your cake hole. That was quite funny.
What the fuck's happened to Cos? The fuck's happened to you?
Don't.
What?
You all right, Cos?
Yeah, yeah.
We'll be right back.
11:12 p.m.
I just had a mouthful of hot chili. My mouth's on fire. Two bites was enough.
Where did you get it from?
Oh, there, we got a bag of them.
Have we?
Mm. Want one?
No, thanks. I think I'm hot enough, Dave.
Yeah, you are
hot. I need to start eating chilies.
You are hot.
Cooker's hot enough.
Beautiful.
Tiny me.
Chilies are taking it way too far.
You were giving me a hard time.
A lot.
Tomorrow you must be nice to me. It will be a new day tomorrow.
You think it's a bit awkward?
No.
I feel a little bit awkward.
Sorry about that. I don't feel at all awkward. I feel happy. Mario.
Is it light out there, or is it just those lights?
It's just those lights.
Follow this. Follow this. You will fall for Ben's charms.
Oh, fuck off.
Ben couldn't charm his way out of a paper bag.
Clearly not.
Now that we're all onto the charm radar. That's a shame, that is, Ben. I really liked you. Before I knew about, you know...
Before you knew
your
about
playeristic
what?
Ways.
Hardly.
Oh, it would be the greatest love story never told.
Yeah. I'd rather be hit 100 times than never be myself with someone.
You're lucky then, aren't you?
Not
well,
really.
Remember when we had to write down the five things
broken.
We wanted to do?
Well, at least I can get it broken.
Yeah, but it hasn't happened to me. I thought I was in love.
You give up everything for them, your job, your friends.
Has that happened to you before?
Yeah.
How many times?
Once.
You're the last of the great romantics.
If I'm the last of the great romantics, you're like my arch nemesis because you're like, you know.
I'm a romantic.
Yeah,
all my
to
friends.
Everyone.
I'm just me. I'm not perfect. I've got lots of things that aren't great about me. I think I've got one or two things that are okay about
you
me.
You are a player, though. You're a bona fide every person. Why would everybody say it about you if there was nothing to...
Yeah, but they're doing it to wind me up, though. They're doing it to tease me, not to tease you.
But why would they say that if you've done nothing at all to indicate
that you are?
Because
they find it bizarre that I'm able to talk to lots of people in different ways, and I am able to talk
but
to
But that's the thing, you don't talk to people in different ways, you talk to everyone with the same wine.
One thirty-five a.m. So far today, housemates have incurred 26 fails in the ignore the obvious task.
This is one task that's going to break us as a house into chaos. I can see it, can you?
I don't know.
This is the one task that we're all going to be at each
other. Dude, I might blow it totally tomorrow. I might just totally fail it for everyone. If one of my mates there, or my wife's there, or anyone's there, dude. I might just end up being just coercing for 10, 15 minutes. You know what I mean? I know it's really selfish and I shouldn't do it.
It's only one fail at the end of the day, and it would just be one fail. Like, if it was my missus and I swept her off into the hut and got all loved up on her in the hut, right? Dude, that would only be one fail. I would just have incurred one fail.
I think we should go to bed right now.
Why?
I think we should go to bed.
Why?
I think we should go to bed right now.
Nothingness going on right now in the glory.
So that nothing going on.
Someone been on the back?
I told you to stay off that powder.
Oh, nothing's going on tonight.
I know.
Absolutely nothing.
I don't know what to do. I'm so bored of all this nothing going on.
Two fifty-four AM. Most of the housemates are asleep. John James and Dave are in the living room.
Andrew's a bit funny with me. He's not a big fan.
I think he really likes Josie. I think he's got a crush on her. So that he'd said some stuff in the diary room regarding him and Josie, or his thoughts on Josie, which would put him in a bad light with you.
Like, every time me and her are together, he walks out of the room. Like, it's obvious, like, she doesn't pick up on it because she's fucking, she's not the full dollar. She doesn't pick up on a lot of shit, but he's admitted that he hasn't had much attention off girls, and she's probably given him more attention than probably what most girls have in a long time, do you know what I mean? And there's nothing wrong with that. And obviously he's developed, like, a little crush on that, and obviously, like, it's going to make it hard for me to be in that situation. I will never stand in the way. But she needs to know. Can you just listen to David? Just listen to him.
We were just talking and he was talking about Andrew. He was basically saying, you know, he doesn't think Andrew likes him. And I said, there's a reason for that. And basically I was just telling him that the reason is he's obviously got some, like, kiddie crush on you. He really likes you and whatever. And he thinks he said a few things in the diary room regarding you. He's obviously gone in there and he said he really likes you and he wished it was an opportunity for you guys to sort of get closer or whatever, but obviously you're around and he probably thinks that's going to turn then your fans against him. That's why he's so worried that he's going to be going. It's one of these kiddie crushy things, you know what I mean?
He needs to get back to Specsavers.
This week, Andrew, Ben, Dave and John James face eviction from the Big Brother house. Who goes? You decide. To evict Andrew, call 090 11 323 015. To evict Ben, call 090 11 323 001. To evict Dave, call 090 11 323 004. To evict John James, call 090 11 323 007. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline. Calls from other networks may be higher, and from mobiles will cost considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Voting closes in Friday's show. To see how the housemates are getting on, ignoring the obvious, go to channel4.com/Big Brother.